under the constitutional issue of reintroducing the mace, which was withdrawn from the assembly, which is a symbol of authority and a symbol of the link between the executive and the parliament, back to parliament. Because the person who should do that is the head of the executive, who now at this particular time is suffering serious lack of legitimacy from the people. And people can demand, the president can resign from a seat, he can vacate a seat at any single time if he loses the legitimacy from the people. But we all know how most of the African leaders try to refuse to step or to respect the rule of law, and that is what we have suffered even in this particular country. And I think this, as I mentioned in my earlier statement, this is a challenge that we face, because the people who are now leading us at the top, most of them got into leadership when the system that was there was one that just looked at selfish interest without regard to any rule of law. As in, mtu hana kazi na sheria. Yeye bora unajua nani, umeshikwa, unalipana kitu. Si hapo nipo mambo ya kitu kidogo ilitoka, no police respect, na respect sheria. Ukienda kwa wanakushika kiholela, unatolewa, unatoka. Hata saizi naona wanatrip. Mara ya kwanza hata hizi protests zikianza, si walikuwa wanashikashika watu hivyo kiholela, until mawakili walipoanza kuprovide legal support kwa wananchi kuelewa haki zao. So ni jukumu letu sisi wote kama wananchi la kuweza kujua kuwa tuko na haki za kuweza ku demand accountability kwa these leaders. Juu, if a leader is corrupt, if someone is in governorship and is corrupt, they're supposed to step down. We saw during, though there were political, obviously, step and measures being taken during Uhuru's time, but I think some of the governors lost their position because they had matters in court involving corruption, like Governor Sonko. So the only challenge we have had is follow-ups and follow-ups on these people, and to ensure we recover the loot and the money that was taken, and to demand that these people, they step down and leave government, and we take them to jail so that they can know, even those jails and those prisons, which have very poor living condition, because we have clients there and you're going to see them and you can see the kind of life wanaishi. Now we have relatives who also live there. Until these politicians start stepping into those doors, those prisons will never be have any good living condition. Until ile siku wataanza kushikwa wakifungiwa huko, it will remain to be a poor man's place, a poor man's space, where the only thing that you can see there is a poor living condition. They are not even offering the rehabilitation that we intend to do. So ile kitu nataka kusema, you know, over and above on all these issues, ni kuwa the systems need to start working independently and interdependently without interference ya watu binafsi, where kuwa kama ni prisons inaweza fanya kazi mtu, ama mtu kama ni police anaweza kushika hata ukiwa wewe ni nani, na akupeleke kwa prison, ni police station, akufungie kulingana na haki zile za, kama umefanya makosa, ukipelekwa kwa mahakama ikufunge, even if wewe ni politician ama wewe ni nani, na upelekwe kwa prison. Lakini siku hizi unanga Kenya, politician akipelekwa industrial area, anasemekananga he has a stomach problem, aende akalale Nairobi Hospital. So atakaa Nairobi Hospital, and most of them, and the good thing I like Sonko, he's always very honest. He has, in most number of times, say that some of these things, wasemanga ni viutoke kulala nini, usilale industrial area. So people have been put in a way that, and I like the lady who was speaking earlier, Ivy, that kuna these classifications za wananchi, za social classes, to a point that kama you have been born in this category of life, the government has put in place all the mechanisms to ensure you don't cross the other side. And those who are on the other side, they are always putting up walls higher and higher so that we don't get there. So it is so unfortunate that as a country we are facing this, but the sweetness about all this is what we have said and we have seen, and we continue to see the unrelentless spirit. We were told at first that the chaos are being sponsored by former President Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Then we were told they are being sponsored by opposition. Then we were told they were being sponsored by civil societies. Now we are being told they are sponsored by some American organization.